I did not know the full story.
Oh my gosh, wait, what?
My jaw just like dropped.
What was that?
I told you so.
I wish that Sarma had felt that she could reach out to the people that were closest to her at Pure.
Because we would have been there for her.
I have more questions, actually. My name is Bonnie, and I was a manager at Pure Food & Wine.
Hi, my name is Jim. I was the operations manager at Pure Food & Wine.
Hi, I'm Mike, and I worked at Pure Food & Wine for 8.5 years.
My name is Nick. In the mid-2000s, I opened Pure Food & Wine as a server, and then I became a floor manager. And then I went on to help Sarma start the business One Lucky Duck.
My name is Nikki, and I was previously the executive chef at Pure Food & Wine.
I'm Joey Repiche. I was the longest standing employee at Pure Food & Wine. I worked there for 10 years.
The walls were all like dark and moody and red, and the seats were red. And I think Sarma really sort of espoused this theory that it should be a very romantic, sexy restaurant. She wanted the food to feel sexy and the clientele were very sexy.
The garden was just an oasis.
A mini empire, if you will.
Rue McClanahan, a golden girl, Blanche, came into the restaurant. I texted Sarma saying, could we please give Rue McClanahan a cookbook?
Someone on the other line says, we'll be there in 20 minutes with former President Bill Clinton. And we're like, is this real?
It was Woody Harrelson, the magician David Blaine. When they were finished with their lunch, they went back out and the city of New York had towed their motorcycles. And so they were just sitting on that front sort of kind of garden level patio in front of the restaurant. And I had to take my shot. And I asked him to do a trick for me and he did like the coolest trick that's ever been done.
I turned to my left and like literally David Blaine is like levitating right beside me.
They called up and they said, hey, you know, I know you're just about to close, but we want to come in. We're with Stevie Wonder. Can you help us out? And I was like, yes. I didn't even ask the chef. I was just, yes. Everything was a song. You know, we brought a dish to him and I said, this has a balsamic reduction. And he's like, balsamic reduction.
People were so talented at this restaurant and Sarma supported all of us.
I still look back with such, you know, fond memories of how supportive and how much she championed me.
We had a great environment in the kitchen. Friendly, we loved each other, we really created a family.
I met my partner there. She and I have been together for 7 years.
And the most incredible thing that happened at Pure Food & Wine is that I got to meet my wife.
To do holidays together, even at the restaurant, we would have, you know, a big Thanksgiving.
I look back and I'm like blown away by how cool the people were that worked there.
It seems like a death in a way. We all have our good memories, but we'll never have those garden nights again.
There was so much more than just a job that was lost in that place.
We were making it, or so we thought. And so my biggest question was why? And I think that's the biggest question everyone has.
What happened to the money? What was Shane, AKA Anthony, doing?
Didn't track for Sarma, for the answer to be like, Sarma just gave all this money to this guy. That didn't make any sense for what she wanted to do or for anything.
I was like, holy shit, I didn't know shit.
One thing that was a surprise for me was finding out that Michael Cortolano, who Sarma introduced me to as an investor for Pure Food & Wine, it turns out that was actually Anthony, and I did not know that. I was on email threads with this person.
The money that just kept flying out of, you know, the transfers that just kept happening, it was just shocking, really. I was just blown away.
I think the most surprising piece was that they posted up in Vegas for like 10 months. I was just there for a wedding and after 4 days, I was exhausted. Like I could not do anything. And it just made me go like, who could live in Vegas for 10 months and not just go batshit crazy?
There were over 100 employees there before they lost their jobs. They didn't get paid. And I didn't think that Sarma really showed any empathy for that.
I think people are still going to be polarized about Sarma and what she went through.
He was promising money, he was promising that her debt would go away, he was promising that she was gonna be immortal or whatever. it's just hard because I feel like I have such a skepticism like deep in my core that I'm like, it's too good to be true.
Sarma's journey was sort of fraught with insecurity, maybe too focused on trying to be the best in other people's eyes.
I would appreciate having her reach out and just connect to us.
I still feel like there's some mystery surrounding the whole story. And maybe we'll find out, or maybe we won't.
Since leaving Pure Food & Wine, bounced around a couple of restaurants, the pandemic hit, and now I'm currently working at a restaurant in Harlem, managing family, travel, and just being present in the now.
I live in Miami now, and just through all my plant-based experience, I am seeing like more and more demand for people that want to learn more about plant-based cooking. So I started a consultancy and it's called Mostly Vegan. And with Mostly Vegan, it's my goal to help small businesses or existing businesses learn more about plant-based food.
We bought a house in the Mid-Hudson Valley region of New York. Right now I'm a baker and I'm going to school online at Oregon State University. I'm pursuing a sustainability degree. I started school during the pandemic with the hopes of maybe getting out of the service side of the restaurant industry and doing something with the operations again, the way that I did at Pure Food & Wine, but focusing on the sustainability of food service.
I launched and created a hot sauce. It was made for the love of my life. It's, you know, predominantly roasted pepper forward, very flavor forward. And my wife and I moved to Oregon and I'm 100% focused on, you know, Joey's hot sauce.
So I moved back to Denver in 2019, but I met a woman shortly after I moved back and we're now married. We're trying to have a family. So that sort of sounds lovely right now. At this phase of my life.
My husband and I live in California where we're raising our two cats. I am a funeral coordinator and bereavement minister and grief counselor. We never had like a funeral or a memorial or anything for Pure. You know, I was across the country when things really ended, but a lot of my friends and staff, they were there for that. We sort of haven't gotten to They haven't had any closure, and none of us have had it really either.
Parts were extremely painful to watch. Tragic. This is so sad.
Be honest. Just be honest.
Don't light money on fire.
You never really know what another person's going through, no matter how well you think you know them. I hope people will take away from this that empathy is important.
Stay connected to people that you love. Don't isolate.
Pure Food & Wine family, miss you guys. Hope we could do it again.